It happened on the night of August 23rd, 1974.
I just sort of turned around and there was this thing about 100 foot away.
John Lennon saw it, and so did his girlfriend, May Pang.
And I'm screaming, it's a UFO!
But only now, 23 years later, are people taking the first close look at this long-lost episode, A Day in the Life of a Beatle. And for the first time, May Pang is revealing the long, hidden sketches made by John Lennon of what he saw. And stranger still, some are even taking a closer look at John Lennon's death and the possibility that it was linked to something he wasn't supposed to see or talk about.
It must be a flying saucer, but you don't want to face it, you know?
John Lennon's apparent close encounter came at a time after he'd left the Beatles. He was living in New York City, fighting a U.S. government attempt to deport him. He was under surveillance by the FBI because of his left-wing political activities. And he was separated from his wife, Yoko Ono, living with his one-time assistant, May Pang, in a penthouse on East 52nd Street.
We were finishing up the Walls and Bridges album that John had been working on. And he decided to take a walk out on our terrace. And now, mind you, he is nude.
But if John Lennon made quite a sight, it was nothing compared to what May Pang says they were both about to see for themselves.
And all of a sudden I hear him yelling out to me, going, May, come out here. So I go running out to the terrace. And I go, what is it? I mean, what? And I stopped. And I looked up and I saw this. The saucer-like thing over our head, just going over us very, very slowly, like a snail. And as it was flying over us, it just sort of wavered. It just tilted, went on sort of on its side a little. And I'm screaming, it's a UFO! And there was no noise coming out of it. That's what was amazing. And it just hovered over this building for a good 5 minutes. It turned around and it moved out and it just went straight up into the sky. We just watched it go straight up.
John Lennon didn't keep the sighting to himself. He called the police and they told him they'd already gotten 3 calls. He called a newspaper. They'd gotten 6. Within days, John Lennon was also on the phone to a radio station where he spoke to all who were tuned in.
I just sort of turned around and there was this thing about 100 foot away. And very low, below the height of the buildings, you know? And I'm thinking, what is it? And I think, it's a flying saucer. It must be a flying saucer. But you don't want to face it, you know? Even if you're a freak like me, you still want to think, oh, it's a balloon or something, you know?
In the years since the sighting, John Lennon's testimony has been available to the public. There's the photograph where he documented the place where he saw the craft. There's even this message he had printed on the cover of the Walls and Bridges album he was making at the time of the sighting. Perhaps the first million-selling affidavit. But there's something else that's been tucked away for more than 2 decades, literally kept in a vault.
This is an envelope that I saved over the years, since 1974, which is a picture that John actually drew, and it's his... It's his version, it's his drawing of what this saucer looked like. So here's the white lights all around, and here was the bright red steady light on top.
And here's where the story takes a twist into the unknown. It was shortly after the sighting and completion of the Walls and Bridges album that John Lennon reunited with Yoko Ono and retired from the music business and public life for 5 years. May Pang has but one regret, that her former lover, John Lennon, was not granted his fondest wish to be beamed up by the UFO and taken away. Maybe then, he'd still be alive. In some other time. In some other place.
I just remember having a conversation shortly thereafter. John's looking at him and he's saying, he goes, I wish they had taken me. He would like to have gone.